Hi, this is Exuro here for Pyroterra Lighttoys, and today I'm going to show you how to use the LtComposer 3 software that we've just come out with. I'm really excited about it. It makes building your shows with your visual poi and your FT devices a snap. What you see on the screen might look a little complicated, but I can assure you that it is not. Everything here is very straightforward and simple when you get down to the basics of it. If we're going to zoom back out here, we're going to see that we've got a lot of things on our timeline, and I'm going to explain how all that works in a minute. First, we're going to go over some basics. We've got our menu bar at the top. We've got our toolbar here, where we can snap to some different points in the song on our timeline. We've got a bit of information there. We've got the status bar on the bottom here, where you can see if you've got your devices connected. We also have this edit box. Whenever you've got an element selected, it's going to display some neat information for you to play with. We've also got our media library window, and these are any images. If you want to change the images that you're looking at, you can open a new image library here. And the last and most important thing is the preview window. And whenever we're playing our show, all of our devices are going to appear in this window. We have some options to look at animated, static, or vertical views of the devices. So let's go ahead. We're going to get started. I'm going to create a new project. If you're curious about any of the hotkey shortcuts that we've got, just press F1. And this information window will pop up. You can take a look and see there's a lot of interesting things that you can use to add things onto your timeline or within the program. So you're gonna see me use this M function to add markers to the timeline quite a bit here. So we've got our new project here. And first thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go ahead and add some music to this timeline. We can load music from here, but I prefer to use the drag and drop function. So we're gonna go ahead and pull in this track by Scats called Easy Orange. Shout out to Scats for letting me use his music for my projects. Really appreciate that. And so we can see the waveform of the music on our timeline. I'm gonna go ahead and quickly use that M key to add some markers onto this timeline. So I'll just do that real quick, and you'll see a bunch of them appear on the timeline momentarily. So now I've got a whole bunch of marks put on this timeline. You can get as intricate as you want, going to all of the little highs and lows on your waveform for your sound. The main idea is that you can use this to snap your elements to these markers on your tracks down here. So we can see I can easily snap to this marker and then select where it's going to go. So if you've used the LtComposer software before, you're going to be familiar with dragging and dropping things onto the timeline for visual poi. So I'm just going to take any of these images over in the library here and put them onto the timeline over here. So I'm just quickly going to throw a bunch of these onto this timeline. And I'm not going to worry too much about how many markers I've got here. Those are more for when we get into the FT devices. So we'll just throw these onto this timeline quickly. So now I've got a bunch of patterns thrown onto this timeline here. I'm just gonna rename this track to my visual poi. And we see I've got it set for visual poi classic, the 136 pixels. Now, let's just say I'm satisfied with this track for now. We're gonna go ahead and add a new track. I'm gonna give it a name. And I want to know what this toy is, so I'm just going to call it by name. To set the actual device, we're going to go up to the corner here and click device, and I'm going to set this one to the V4 Maxi, and we can see now it's set for 200 pixels. I'm going to take and throw these hard eye emojis onto this timeline so that we can show a feature here. We've got this real-time function, where we can see that this hard eye emoji is going to repeat 381 times across this area. But we can only see about 10 in this image. If I take and click the real time, we can see exactly what it's going to appear like. If I zoom in, I can start to see more of these hard eye emojis happening in different areas here. I'm going to go ahead and add another track below this one by selecting duplicate track. So now I've got another track exactly identical to the one that I had selected. But this one I want to be a Visual Poi Mini. So I'm going to name it what I'm thinking it's going to be. Again, go up and select the device. Now I'm Visual Mini. And we can see we've got three different devices here. In the real-time function now, though, we can see that the Visual Maxi and Mini are displaying a different number of these hard eye emojis per second or per spin, depending on what your perspective is. They're going to be 5 per spin up there, and it looks like 15 or so down here. And in the same period of time, we've got 380 going on the Maxi and a little over 1,000 going on the Mini. But let's say I want the same number of them to happen every second. The way that I can do that is I'm going to go ahead and remove that block. I'm going to take and click lock sizing on the block that I want to have look exactly the same. Using that control click function, I'm going to drag that onto the new timeline. And when we zoom in, we can see that it's going to have the same number, 381 in this case, of the hard eye emojis. I don't actually want the hard eye emojis in this show though, so I'm going to take those out and we're going to load in a new set of images here. I'm going to go up to Media, Open Image Library, and we can pick basically whatever we want. So I'm going to go ahead and select something off the desktop here that I've got. We've got a set of patterns that we made just in, you know, you can make them in Microsoft Paint, whatever you want. A lot of basic looking images in here. And we're going to go ahead and take this one and place it on the timeline. Now I've still got the real-time function enabled. And what this is going to do is shows me I've got about 18 repeats of what is essentially the bar just slowly filling up on the Visual Maxi here. If I go ahead and click play, we can see the bar is just filling up rapidly. But I only want it to repeat that one time. I want the bar to fill up slowly. So we're going to set that to 1. And we're going to lock sizing. I'm going to copy that down to the other track. And now when I hit play, we can see that both the Visual Mini and the Maxi are going to fill up at the same rate here. If I don't have that lock sizing function on, it's not going to fill at the same rate. I'll have to manually adjust the number of repeats. We can also use this slider scale to adjust the number of repeats here. There's some limitation on what the maximum and minimum is going to be. You can see we can't quite get down to 1 with the slider, but we can still set it to 1 here on our own. I'm just going to throw a bunch of patterns onto this timeline here, and then we're going to go from there and start adding some FT devices to this. So now that I've got a bunch of patterns thrown onto these other devices here, I'm going to go ahead and uncheck real time, and we're going to go back to the view that you're familiar with for the previous versions of the LtComposer. If you're only using visual devices, this is enough for you and you don't have to watch any further. But we're going to go ahead and start adding some FT devices here. So I'm going to add a new track, and you'll see as we start adding more tracks, we can slide this view up, and I'm going to go ahead and we can expand view if we want to have everything be a little bit bigger. I prefer to use the collapsed view. And I'm going to add 5 more tracks here. We're going to call these some different things. And now we're going to go ahead and select our devices here. This is going to be an AB device with the FT technology in it. And you'll see now it splits this particular track into 2 here. If I expand view, it's a little more obvious. We've got the A segments and the B segments on this timeline. But again, I'm going to collapse the view. And I'm going to set all of these tracks to AB functionality. And now we're getting to the good stuff. So you'll see in this FT selector, we've got a couple different elements right now. You'll probably see some more there in the future. I'm going to go ahead and take a solid color. We can choose the default color of that block up there on this color wheel. I can hold shift and it lets us snap to some automatic colors. And you'll see that every time I pick a new color, it appears on this bar on the right side. So if you want to quickly use a color that you've previously used, you can just click on that bar. So we're going to set my default color to this blue here. And now I'm going to drag and drop onto this timeline. I can set it as just the A channel, or if we hold and hover between the A and the B, we can set it to the A and the B channels here. Now, something neat is we can do that control click and drag these blocks onto different segments to duplicate them, and we can make our show pretty interesting very quickly. Those of you who've used the previous coding program for the FT devices, you are probably really thrilled right now in this moment that you can do something like this so quickly. So these are the color blocks. If we want to say change the color of some of these blocks, we'll just go over here to this slider wheel and I can select a different color for these blocks here. And I'll select a different color for these blocks here. So we've already got something interesting going on. If we take a look at the top here, you can see that it's all jumping around up here, and it makes the show pretty interesting already. Now we've got the gradient block. If I go ahead and drop it onto this timeline, the gradient block changes from one color to another color. And we can go ahead and select that first color or the second color. And we can make it, say, go from green to blue, or from blue to green, or from red to green. And then we also have this option which lets you swap the colors and switch that gradient block. So we can take one, put it to the end of the other, turn it around, and now it's going to go from red to green to red again. So this is the basics of how to use these color blocks for the FT devices. So I'm going to remove what I've got on this timeline here, and I'm going to put something more interesting on this timeline. And so you're just going to see me quickly add a bunch of elements here, make some little blinking patterns. We can be as creative as we want to be and make little blinking patterns that happen here and duplicate them as we see fit. Okay, now I have gone through and spent about 30 minutes adding some interesting things onto this timeline. Again, anyone who's been familiar with the FT programming thus far, you're going to see that I've instantly gone about 100 times faster in the programming of the devices just by having these timelines. We've got a lot of interesting things on the timeline, some different blinking patterns that I've made pretty quickly here. Throwing some things onto the A and the B segments on some of these, throwing them onto both of them in some other areas. And all of this is going to look pretty interesting here when we hit play on the timeline. One last thing that I want to talk about is if you try and drag a visual element onto the FT timeline, you're going to see it appear gray and have this little exclamation mark on it, indicating that you can't actually do that. The device isn't going to recognize an image because it's not set up to display images. However, it works the opposite way though. We can take these FT elements and I can copy them onto the visual timeline, and we can have all of our devices blink in unison. The FT elements can work on the visual timeline. The visual elements cannot work on the FT timeline. So we're gonna go ahead, we're gonna zoom out, and we can see the full project here. You can get as intricate as you want. You definitely don't have to be this detailed, but you know, I like to do it a little over the top. So we're gonna go ahead and we're gonna push play and we're gonna watch some of the things that we've made here appear. I'm gonna click between the static, animated, and vertical views, and I hope you've enjoyed this tutorial. Thank you for watching. My name is Exuro. This has been the tutorial on how to use the Pyroterra Lighttoys LtComposer 3 software for both visual and FT devices. Thanks for watching, and let the light be with you. Be prepared.